Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Ancient Warrior, and welcome back to Prepping in Free America. If you like what you hear here, hit the subscribe button. If you want to be the first kid on your block to know what craziness I'm talking about next, hit the bell icon with all. And leave comments. Let me know which way to take the channel. I don't know what to do if you don't tell me. I guess you kind of got it by the thumbnail that I'm going to be talking about stupid things. Let me show you a bag I got. Let's see. It says, open first before wearing. This is a pair of pants that I got from LAPD gear out of California. Now, do they really think I'm going to wear these things folded up in that bag? Come on. It's kind of like the plastic bags that says, do not let children play with, suffocate. Suffocation hazard? No. Let's talk about stupid things. I got wound up this morning. I crossed my news feed on my computer. Actually, it comes through from Breitbart, for those of you that LeBron James, the mental midget. I'm not a basketball fan, folks. I am not a basketball fan. That's basketball and golf fit in the same category with me. Taking a little white ball or a little orange ball and putting it through a hoop or into a pocket in the ground. I mean, come on. And I've tried to play golf one time, well, several times. That just wasn't my game. Now I can go sit in a hunting blind all day and all night, and it doesn't bother me. But trying to put a little white ball into a cup, ain't happening. And I tried in high school, back in school, I tried to play basketball, and I always had the one major hang up. I wasn't tall enough. I was always the shortest kid on the team. Now, well, let's talk about LeBron James's comment about Kyle Rittenhouse. He couldn't believe that Kyle Rittenhouse broke down in tears on the stand the other day. We got an old warbird flying around. I can tell by that engine. I hadn't heard that type of engine in a long time. Well, number one, LeBron James has no idea what Kyle Rittenhouse is going through. What he has gone through for the last year. No idea whatsoever. And it really does infuriate me. Now, guys who have been in combat understand what this kid's going through. I've got to look to see what it is. Oh my gosh. Veterans Day always brings the best out. We just had a P-51 Mustang and a Hellcat and two other smaller aircraft fly over. You could hear them. Those planes just excite me. Old cars excite me. Now, back to what we were talking about, Kyle Rittenhouse. Any veteran who's been through combat and had to take a life understands what this kid's going through. Any cop who's had to take a life knows what this kid's going through. And this kid is 18 years old right now, so he was 17 when this happened. And the Mockingbird media, you know, the CIA controlled, well, they're no longer CIA controlled, I don't believe. I think it's Democrat controlled media. Wants this kid crucified. They want to make sure that nobody else ever does that again. Really? You want to see what happens when people get pushed into a corner and fear for their lives? You're going to see a lot worse than that. I also have been waiting to see I'm having to answer a text here, folks. I do apologize, but I have a friend who broke both of his feet, and I'm trying to help the family through some problems. But back to what we were talking about. Any cop who's had to shoot somebody knows what this kid's going through. The only advantage with military and law enforcement is they get somebody to talk to. If they want it, they've got somebody to talk to. This kid, he's on his own. And the Democrat-controlled media is trying to railroad this boy into a prison cell. Guys and gals, I'm here to tell you right now, from what I've watched on this deal, which hadn't been a whole lot, just kind of clips of it, if they convict Kyle Rittenhouse of murder or any other thing, they're planning to burn Kenosha down. If they don't convict him of something. If he gets off, the leftists are going to burn Kenosha to the ground. And folks, let me tell you something. The sad part is, you'll see more of this. Because people are sick and tired. The Democrats, back on the 2nd of November, were giving a mandate by the people. And that mandate was, stop the crap. These people do not understand. The American people, I don't care if they're Republican, Democrat, Independent, Green Party, or what, they all want one thing, and that's to be safe walking down the streets. And folks, if you go to a Democrat-controlled city, then you probably aren't. This morning, across my news feed, I got a deal that says that the police chief in L.A. has said that if robbers confront you, just give up your stuff. Don't even fight with them. Really? I guess California is becoming more and more of the Wild West. And I don't think they're going to like what's going to happen. Eventually, people are going to get tired. And they're going to want a better life for themselves. They're either going to leave the state, or they're going to arm themselves and take the state back. Americans don't know how to be. Most Americans, let me correct that. Most Americans do not know how to be good little drones. We're rebels at nature. From 1776 on, we have been fighting. Not only with others, but among ourselves. So, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have a blessed Veterans Day. And to all my brothers and sisters who wore the uniforms, may God bless you. May you always find peace. And may your sleep be nothing but great. And remember, it's better to have this equipment, not need it, than need it, and not have it. And because of our veterans, we haven't needed it. And if you're prepping, you're going to live free. I'm the Ancient Warrior. We're out.